you know, at the beginning, there was a... It was strange because, you know, you pick up this project, this title that I had been familiar with as a kid, and it feels childish. And then you see an actor of the stature of Edward James Olmos tell you it's the most important story he's ever worked on. And then you just go, oh, well, that doesn't make any sense because it's kind of goofy. And then you had to assimilate what Mary and Eddie were bringing was a real, obviously, pedigree and a seriousness and a commitment to it. And then on a personal level, it was very important because it was a big break and you don't want to screw it up. You want to... You know, you want this to help in your chosen profession. So, you know, they changed it immediately. Just the way they brought a sense of gravitas to the subject matter, and I'll never forget the day that Eddie, we were being walked through the sets, and he just wanted everything messed up, like these beautiful science fiction shiny sets. He wanted them all messed up, and they said, "Hey, we're going to do that. And he said, "No, I mean, I'm really messed up. I want this to be falling." And he walked around the whole place, and that was a sort of little image of what he did, you know, for us as actors. He just wanted everything to have that dirt under the fingernails, and from the performances to the costumes to the look of the whole thing. So many memories of, you know, different days and watching different performances, and we all grew up. You know, the younger actors all, you know, grew up on that set. They were 5 years of my life that took me from being single to having three kids and married, and same, you know, my friend James Callis also had two kids during the shoot. You know, we changed during the whole process, and the show changed us, and the people we worked with changed us. Michael Reimer changed me as I remember at the very beginning he sat us down and said, "Let's talk about your character and let's talk about what we can do with this character." And no writer or director had ever asked my opinion before, ever. Working in Britain, I was just told to read the lines and, you know, not screw up and hit your marks, and we'll go home afterwards and have a pint in wherever we were staying. But so it was empowering, and Ron Moore too. By the end, you know, the writers were encouraging us to, you know, share ideas, and it was giddy. It was a really special time.